Wellness Gala is going live.
What did you say?
It should pop up and say Wellness Gala is going live, or Joe is going live. Oh, here it is. Here it goes. It says Wellness Gala is going live now.
Okay.
Where do you see it?
Yeah, I see you. I see you.
Where do you see it? We don't see it.
Mine popped up on my screen. I don't. It just said Wellness Gala is going live. Hi, do you see me?
That's all right. Let me go. Twice is a charm.
All right, you're on. Okay, Joe, you're on live. It's working.
Okay. Sorry about the technical foul. I had a nice warm up.
All right.
Deb and the Wellness Gala for this opportunity, and we're going to work a little bit of seated Tai Chi. I'm on the ground. If you choose to sit in like a loose lotus, try this from the ground. That's fine. Otherwise, if you go in a chair, try to get an armless chair.
Jen, I don't see him.
All right, so you have to think loose. Most important thing, drop your shoulders, slow down your breath work. So we're going to come up. Hand. Basic posture. This is your teapot. All right?
Don't hang up with
China.
Him.
So we're going to come from here. And scoop. Loose. Scoop with the wrist. Look. Extend the arm out. We're going to drop this shoulder back. I need you to work this later. Looseness around. Now think about throwing pixie dust. You want to be loose through here. So scoop. Loose. Circle the torso. Till here. Now lift. Palm toward the ceiling. Begin to turn it till it's straight overhead. Turn. Dip. So you're going to stretch your obliques here, but still staying relatively loose. Hand. Part the air in front of you. And when we get to this back move, watch what I do here as this loops around. We turn the wrist and come out. So you need to loosen the wrist. So as I'm coming in back here, we turn out on an angle. Look, turn out, retract. And from here, come back around, up. We're undoing what we did before. Come across the body. Head follows the body. Across, unscoop. Okay, so one more time. That's the basic premise of the form. Teapot. Scoop. Look. Relax. Drop your shoulders. The eyes stay right in front of the thumb. Lift. Turn. My head is turning with my hand. Push the air. Here is our wrist switch. Strike. So it's actually a little kung fu there. Strike, snap it. Some fast twitch. Muscle work. And reverse what you did. So now I'm coming with the back of my hand. Twist. Down and pull it back. Switch, scoop, look, drop the shoulder back and down, up, turn. Stretch the obliques, lean forward, circle around, come back around. Fuck. Turn. In front. And across. Two hands. Scoop. Turn, lean forward. Turn the hands. All right. Fast. Bring it back. Push. Drop your shoulders. Come across. Unscoop and set. Now there's a whole foot sequence that goes with this, but right now get the hands. You want to get this body twist, all right, from the side. As I do this move, look how much I twist, okay? And being seated, it doesn't allow my hips to move at all, so it's all waist and obliques in here, okay? Moving around. So we can do this a little faster, but you don't want to increase the tightness in your body. So I can come around here and scoop. And we can move through a little quicker. Up. Out. Granted, I've been doing this a while. Notice, though, how my head and my torso and my body follow my arms here. So as we come across, stay loose, and you can move fast. There's no friction right now except the air. And then if we double scoop, twist, twist the wrist back, come up, and through. So the full form is called White Dragon Serves Tea. My Sifu showed it. This was the first form he showed me. I always loved it. Great foot sequence too. That can be for another day. So one more time. Teapot. Scoop. When you scoop, think about scooping gold sand. We don't want to drop any, right? So scoop your golden sand. When you extend, keep your palm up so you don't drop it. It's gold. We don't want to lose it. So around. Keep that palm up. Even as we lift, do not spill the sand. So we're working, flexing back the wrist here. Was very difficult for me initially. Now as we lean, we don't want to spill the sand. Even here, I haven't spilled any yet. As I bring my arm to the rear, okay, and I turn, I didn't spill the sand. I come out, I come back, turn. Let's go back here again, around, up. Notice this really looks sort of like a blade. It's not just coincidental. Moving, come across. Switch, scoop your gold sand. Push it around. Don't spill it. Up. Think about being loose. Twist the arm. You can't do that move without loosening. You're not tightening, you're loosening. And around. Up. sand in my hand. Come across. Drop your sand back in. Two scoops of sand. Now I switch my head as I spin through, looking at both sides. So I'm going to look left here and then right. You don't even have to do them at the same time. As you get better, you can mix those combinations up and come across, drop your sand in. Proper ending would be to take your stopper, put it inside the bottle, and bow. Now, when you do that, okay, so stopper, all right, inside bottle. And when you form this position, you make a yin and a yang here, okay? So that's really what that fist work there at the end is. So stopper, container, yin and yang. That's how it should begin and end. So one more time, slow. Sorry about the optics. I am doing this from my phone. But in these tough times, we learn how to make it work. So all the way through. Remember, we're throwing our energy out here. Lift it up. Think of the color red when you're high and the color blue when you're low. So there's color connections here. Blue as we dip low. Red or orange as we dip high. Scoop. Both. So look one way, then the other. So now we're moving our head. Think red. Think blue. Neutral. Blue. Think red. Now we can make combinations out of this if you want. And I'll say this more than once. I've been doing this for a while now. It was very tough at first. The biggest thing is drop your shoulders and loose. Let your face drop. Let your muscular, all your muscles drop. Shoulders are down. As soon as you lift, you can't do this. You want to be down. No friction whatsoever as I go through these moves, whether it's fast or slow. So let's play around with the how we do this. So let's do the end first. Come in here. This time look the other way. Mm-hmm. right. Think of jelly beans, Easter time. Scoop your jelly beans and around. Don't drop any. Keep the palm facing the ceiling. Turn. Think about turning a balloon up here. This motion. Or maybe we're screwing in a light bulb. And drop. Around. Turn that wrist. Don't drop your jelly beans. Back. Need to lean. Elbow up. So this is linear here. This arm is out this way. This elbow is here. They're kind of opposite much of the time. Okay. Then around. Up. So now I've come over my head. My elbow's pointed back and down. Opposite. And around. Cut across. Tea kettle. I didn't scoop that time. There's no rules. You don't have to scoop. Make this your own. Look. It will stretch your neck. Around. Back. Make sure you're breathing. Hold your breath. You'll be tight. And set. So little things that you do when we turn and look, you want to practice what's called owl eyes. So as I turn here, not only do I turn my body, I am turning my eyes. I'm incorporating my eye movement all the way to the left side of my head. So to increase my range of motion, especially as we get stiffer, as we get old, right? So as I come through here, I'm incorporating the owl into this and moving my eyes as well. So it's not just about moving your head. On this side, while I'm moving my head, I'm also incorporating my eyes into this motion. So I'm bringing them over this way. All right, so let's, you can practice just by turning and looking. On this side, turn, look, incorporate the eyes into your turn because you will begin to lose flexibility in your neck as you get older. If you're younger, you start to practice that now. It'll only work to your advantage. Okay, a couple slightly different exercises. We can come from here and press. Sometimes you'll see people will make heat, okay? Lift. Down. Turn your hands this way. Pull. Like we're making thread. Come back. Lift. Out. Across. Lift. This time I'm bending down. Now, polish the glass. Back. Up. Down. Drop the shoulders. You can do it this way. Very loose, very smooth. Keep the shoulders dropped. Come here. Pulling here. Switching, switching. So think about Spider-Man shooting out the web, pulling it back, shoot out the web, pull it back. So there's all smooth motions. You should practice as often as you can. This is available at my dojo when we do get to officially reopen at Lakeland Karate, and I want to just thank Deb again for this opportunity. You can reach out to me on Facebook, friend me at Joe Sirvent. be safe.